Black licorice. You either love it or hate it. Me, I hate it.
Oh my gosh.
However, our writer loves it, so we'll see how this script goes. Its flavor is hard to describe without comparing it to other foods like anise and fennel. What makes this such a controversial treat? Why is red licorice not licorice? And how can black licorice kill you? Stay tuned as we chew on the sweet facts. This is Black Licorice. In 2020, a 54-year-old Massachusetts man died after eating black licorice. We'll talk about that later. But first, let's get one thing straight. The term black licorice is redundant. All true licorice is black. What North Americans refer to as red licorice is not licorice at all. It's a fruit-flavored candy made to resemble black licorice whips or laces. Most manufacturers don't even call it red licorice. They sell it as twists or vines. I'm partial to the twists myself. People can't even agree how to spell licorice. In North America, it's spelled with a C, while in Europe, it has a QU. However you spell it, the compound glycyrrhizin gives black licorice its color and flavor. Called gansao, or sweet grass in China, this herb has been used for thousands of years in traditional medicine. First enjoyed by the Assyrians, Egyptians, and Chinese, licorice is now grown mainly in Greece, Turkey, and Asia. It's still used in medicinal products today. Ever tasted NyQuil? Yup! But some people like the taste, go figure. I bet the writer just loves it. And medicine isn't the only product that uses licorice for flavor. It's also used in alcoholic drinks, tea, and as a food supplement. One of the reasons this root is so yummy... Nope, I can't say it. It's disgusting. Let's just stick to the facts. Glycyrrhizin, the compound found in licorice, is 50 times sweeter than sugar. This makes it perfect for use in candies. In addition to whips, laces, and twists, licorice is used in gum, hard candies, and all sorts of candies. Yum! No, not yum. Guys, the writer keeps trying to make me say I like licorice. Not gonna happen. I see what Scott's trying to do here. In the Netherlands, licorice is so popular that people eat over 1.8 kilograms per person every year. That's 20% of all the candy sold in the country. But a lot of what we know as licorice candy doesn't have any licorice in it. Much of it's flavored with anise or fennel. These plants have a similar sweet and aromatic flavor without licorice's deadly effects. Wait, what? That hard-to-pronounce compound, glycyrrhizin, in licorice mimics the hormone aldosterone. It can make your body retain too much potassium, throwing off your electrolyte balance. Eventually, your blood pressure will increase and you could have swelling, headaches, and feel unusually tired. It could even lead to heart failure or cardiac arrest. Remember that guy we mentioned earlier? Yeah, he switched from eating red twist to black licorice and ate a bag and a half of the candy every day for a few weeks. The effect on his potassium levels was so dramatic that his heart stopped. He literally died, guys. But that doesn't mean you have to stop eating this delightful treat. Sorry, this candy. As with anything, moderation is key. The United States Food and Drug Administration allows up to 3.1% of a soft candy to be glycyrrhizic acid. So enjoy your disgusting licorice if you want, Scott. Oops, did I just say that out loud? Sorry. Enjoy your licorice if you want, just don't overdo it. And keep it away from me. Let us know what you think about licorice in the comments below. Do you love it or hate it? Either way, I'll still love you. Speaking of love or hate, we'll have a look at another controversial candy, the Cadbury Cream Egg, on another episode of Origins of Food.